Good morning, everybody, and welcome to day 20. I don't know how it got to be day 20 already. Sorry about the noise. I am coming to you from my car this morning, which is not how I planned this day at all. But hey, sometimes we just got to roll with the way that the day goes. Today we're talking about records and record keeping, and I'm going to keep this video really short because there's so much in terms of record keeping, but I decided that what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through it really briefly on this video, and then I will put later this afternoon when I'm back home, I'll share a PDF about the record keeping portion, because it goes through the required record keeping for manufacturers, for packagers, for labelers, and for importers. And so I'll make a chart and go through all four record keeping details so you guys have a really good understanding of what that looks like. So just briefly, I'm going to talk about the manufacturing and the packaging. Sorry, I'm trying to balance my phone here so that I can look at my notes. Bear with me. Like I said, not planned to be in a car today for sure. All right. So every manufacturer who sells a natural health product shall maintain the following records at their sites. These have to be on site and have to be available if Health Canada should ever request them. So we need a master production document for natural health products, a list of all ingredients contained in each lot or batch of your natural health product, records of any testing conducted in respect to the lot or batch, so that's back to our stability testing, records of any testing conducted to the individual ingredients that go into the lot and batch, and then again of the lot and batch itself independently. So for the individual ingredients, that will be the data that you should be getting from your suppliers. So keep a copy of that. Then a copy of the specifications for each natural health product that's being manufactured at site. So that's all those product specs that we went through the other day. Records demonstrating each lot or batch of the natural product was manufactured in accordance with the requirements of good manufacturing practices. So that'll be your checklists and your record keeping, etc. Then records containing sufficient information to enable a recall of every lot or batch of the natural product. So that will be things like your detailed record keeping of retail locations that you have shipped certain lots and batches to, dates of those lot and batches, and the contact information for that specific retail partner. A list of all natural health products that are manufactured on site, and a copy of your sanitation program and your health and hygiene program. So then we move on to every packager who sells a natural health product shall maintain the following records on site: a record of any testing conducted in respect to the material used to package the health products. So if you are manufacturing and packaging, you need separate records for your products and for your packaging, as well as I believe for your labeling, which we'll get into in a minute. So a record of any testing conducted specific to the material. So if you are getting like a recycled propylene bottle that you are putting a shampoo in, you will require the data from your supplier that defines it as a propylene bottle, recycle level 5, let's say. So any supplier should be able to provide you with that. And you need to maintain those records always for every batch that you order from a supplier. Records demonstrating that each lot or batch of the natural health product was packaged in accordance with the requirements of good manufacturing. So we've been through that. Records containing sufficient information to enable a recall. And then a list of all natural health products being packaged on site, not being manufactured, but being packaged. So they could be different. And then a copy of the sanitation program in use at the site. And then we get into labelers. So for labelers, a record demonstrating that each lot or batch of natural health product was labeled in accordance with the requirements. So again, what I do is when I do my spreadsheet, I know that I am the manufacturer, I am the packager, and I am the labeler. So when I make my like giant spreadsheet that feeds into all of my other forms and documents, I actually have on there three different sections for the manufacturing, the packaging, and the labeling, because I do all of that myself at my site. And so that serves as a record for all three of them if it is done correctly, if it is laid out correctly. I don't do any importing, so if you're importing, basically, I'll just finish with the labeling. So a copy of the sanitation and then a copy of all of the natural health products being labeled on site. If you are importing, what you'll need to know is you need to, it says every importer who sells a natural health product shall maintain the following records. And so the list, the master production document for the natural health product. So whether you are manufacturing it or you're not, if you are importing it, you are required to have that master production document. So you need a copy of that from whatever company you're importing it from. You need a list of all ingredients contained in each lot and batch. So maybe it varies from batch to batch. Maybe in one batch your manufacturer used grapeseed oil, and in the other batch maybe they used, I don't know, jojoba oil, and they swapped it out. So every single batch you need a unique list of ingredients for. Then you need any records of testing that was conducted in respect to the lot and batch of the health products. So as a manufacturer, they will be doing the stability testing, and you do need a record of that stability testing from the person you are importing from. You need a copy of specifications for the natural health product. And then you need a record of each determination made by the importer in accordance with Section 52 and the information that supports that determination. So that is if their sites comply with what Health Canada stipulations are, they go through a smoother import licensing process. Like let's say you're importing from the EU or from the US, we have agreements, or from Australia actually, we have agreements with the US, we have agreements with Australia, we have agreements with the EU, because we all follow that IOS 22716-2007. And so if your stuff that you are importing is being manufactured in a site that has already got GMP approval and it's in compliance with IOS 22716, then they will have a special waiver basically for that, and you will need a copy of that. Then as distributors, then you also need a record of your sanitation program. So that has to happen for importers as well. Every distributor needs to maintain the following records on site. So records containing sufficient information to enable a recall. So as a distributor, If you are selling products to retail locations, you are a distributor. And so you need to be able to track what lot and batch went to what retail partner on what date, how many units were there, etc., etc. Because if you ever need to do a recall, you need to be able to bang, have that information on hand immediately. And the sooner you are able to provide that information to Health Canada, the more willing to work with you they are, because they realize that you are working within GMP compliance. And so that's a really big thing. Like it might seem like a lot of paperwork to take care of, but having gone through a recall process myself, I can assure you that if you are immediately or almost immediately able to provide Health Canada with your records and they see that you are actually working within GMP compliance, you are looking at a whole different ball game in terms of the workability between you and Health Canada, and the ease with which a recall can happen. So you'll need that record of all your retail partners, lot batch numbers, number of units that went. You'll need a list of all natural health products that are stored on the site, and then you will need a copy of a sanitation program in use. Now, additionally, a lot of these records can be electronic. Some of these records, of course, are the ones that require sign-off or checklists that require initialing. So I'm going to, this afternoon when I get back home, I was supposed to be at home in my office working this morning, but things didn't work out that way. That's why I'm coming to you from my car. So when I do get back home, I was planning today to have a document, like a desk reference for you guys, that goes through the different roles and responsibilities and what the record keeping responsibilities associated with each role are. And then I will also color code it so that you know which electronic copies are acceptable versus which ones require a sign off. And then I will put that package together, and hopefully if everything goes according to how I'm hoping my day will go now, I should be able to get that up and ready for you guys today, and that will take care of the record keeping portion of the GMP for you guys, for this part. Like, I mean, it's not super in depth, but it is, you know, these are little tips and tricks, I guess. This GMP live feature is why I'm doing it. If you want to get in depth and actually learn to do your own GMP, that's a whole different ballgame. This is just to kind of give you guys an idea of what we're actually attesting to and saying we're already compliant with when we apply for a CNF or when we apply for an NPN. Because in the attestation at the bottom of both those applications, it does imply that by signing, you are working within GMP compliance. And so it's important for you guys to know what GMP compliance looks like. So that is it for now. I will try and get that document up for you guys to print off as a desk reference later on today. And I hope you are all having a fantastic Tuesday. Take care and have a great day now. Bye for now.